Welcome to Brand Bite Size, brought to you by Brand Financial Training. Today, we take a look at the time-weighted rate of return. The time-weighted rate of return, or TWRR, measures the return on capital invested. Each time money comes into or out of the portfolio, a separate calculation is performed. This means that deposits and withdrawals do not influence the final return figure. The return for each period is calculated by dividing the end value by the value at the beginning. Let's take a look at an example. Harry invests £1,000 into a stocks and shares ISA on the 1st of January. By the 1st of April, it's worth £1,200, so Harry invests a further £1,000. By the end of June, the ISA is worth £2,400. To work out the TWRR, we need to establish the return between January and April. We'll call this period 1, and then between April and June, period 2. Period 1 then is the first 3 months when the fund grew from a starting point of £1,000 to £1,200. To work out what that is as a percentage, we take the end value of £1,200 and divide it by the starting point of £1,000. This gives us a figure of 1.2. Deduct the 1, then multiply by 100 to give us the percentage figure, which in this case is 20%. Period 2 is the next 3 months. Because of the additional cash, we have a starting value of the fund plus the further investment of £2,200 and an end value of £2,400. If we divide 2,400 by 2,200, this gives us a figure of 1.0909. Deduct the 1 and multiply by 100 to give us a return of 9.09%. To arrive at the TWRR, we simply multiply those two returns together. 1.2 times 1.0909 gives 1.309. Deduct the 1 and multiply up by 100 to give a TWRR of 30.91%. The process is the same regardless of how many return periods we have. Because the TWRR removes the impact of deposits and withdrawals on returns, it is a helpful measure when comparing portfolio returns. We hope you enjoyed this Brand Bite Size, brought to you by Brand Financial Training. See you next time.